Hi, this is Mike. I just wanted to give you a quick update about the audio in the next four episodes. AP was having some equipment trouble, and we didn't really notice until after the session these next four episodes were recorded in. So there's going to be kind of staticky a little bit whenever he talks. I think we figured out what the problem is, so hopefully it will be done next recording session. But as for episodes 17, 18, 19, and 20, that problem, I've done as much as I can to make it less ear-piercing, but I couldn't get rid of all of it. So very, very sorry about that. Hopefully you guys can stick with us through those four episodes, and hopefully episode 21 and beyond will be better. Anyways, thanks for your patience, and let's get to the game. And we're back with Game Kiwi Plays Yakuza 3. I'm Mike.
I'm another person of AP, and let's see if we can get to Kamurocho this time. I don't think we will.
Let's see.
Like, I'm firmly in the belief that Kamurocho is 20 hours away at this point, based on last recording session.
Oh, right, we have Haruka with us, because we were going to do something in town?
What were we going to do in town?
I don't know.
You don't even have the benefit this time of having just rendered the last episode.
No, I don't. We're doing this well in advance. Want to make sure I'm not going to accidentally skip miserable side quest, but I don't think I am. Okay.
So where exactly are we headed then? What are we doing? Why is Haruka knocking about with us?
Good question. Let me pull up the... the bullet point walkthrough for this game real quick. They can people watch for a second. I'm not going to cut this out. It'll just take a second. I just have to find it.
Actually takes like 20 minutes. These people are going to be so bored, Mikey. Just making them watch it.
Okay. So we hit the baseballs, so, right?
That's the last thing we did. I was actually just about to do the same thing, like look up in a guide exactly where we just got up to see just how far it was until Kamurocho appears. Without actually reading the information. I just got caught up on a game FAQ's mini FAQ section. And question 2. Is this game Shenmue? Question 3. Is this a GTA 4 ripoff? Those classic days of game FAQs where the person writing all the questions was the same person writing the guides.
Yeah. And then that guide has the good bullet point quick walkthrough that I'm using to just kind of guide us.
Oh wow, this guy's a joke.
Yeah. I think we've outclassed Okinawa here.
Mm-hmm. We are more powerful than every Okinawa man right now.
Yeah.
And hell, we even made that very clear by addressing our adopted son in a very Okinawan dominant way.
Yeah.
Making sure they know their position.
He's gonna fucking own this town.
Mm. Do all the kids come back in later games?
Come back? Maybe not come back.
Adi just mentioned as a brief aside. Cause I'll be real disappointed if we don't at least find out what happened with the relationship we set them up on there.
Uh-huh.
Like, I know it's not going to show continuity for fashion decisions, but I'd like to see some continuity for this. The, helping him take her out to see a movie. So, what?
The only problem with that guide on, GameFAQs is that it is a translation guide, so all the place names are a little different. There's an upstairs here? Keys we could have gotten.
Oh man, this is bloody hiding them all. There's gonna be like 5 up here.
If any, I'm not seeing any.
Nah, I don't think I'd be even any help in seeing keys right now just because... Wow, Skype is shitting itself.
One of these
days... There's an actual line?
Discord.
Yeah, one of these days. Mm-hmm. It's gonna happen, man. We said it would happen when we started doing Let's Plays. Still hasn't quite happened.
And it's gonna happen, it's gonna be bad.
Mm-hmm. Right now there's a really obvious split in the screen that I'm seeing.
Great.
Where there's like a line going through, through Kazuma's shirt.
Personally,
and like the top half and his bottom half aren't quite, they're not quite in sync, so like his arms will be moving in different directions based on top and bottom half.
Uh-huh.
It's kind of an odd thing that's happening with Skype right now. Oh god, it's going through this guy's mouth. Also, did Haruka just walk through that guy?
He did.
Just getting the first hit in, man.
Fuck. I keep trying to press dodge like I'm playing Nier.
How far are you into that game?
About 30 hours.
That's a lot of hours. How long is it?
I don't know.
For me, just pick up the statue over there, could you? Oh no, you're gonna end the...
I picked up that statue. You yelled at me last time I picked it up.
Yeah, I know, but I just want to see it happen. It's heat of the moment, Mikey. Heat of the moment.
3,000 yen is not going to get me shit in a hostess club, my dude.
It might get you in a queue. It won't get you in the club.
That's like the fee for requesting a specific person.
You won't be able to talk to them, though. You'll just get to sit across the room from them, maybe?
Wait, what are
you... So what is it we're actually supposed to be doing with Haruka?
The guide says, talk to Haruka in front of the Morning Glory, choose to go with her, go to Ryukyu. Go to the public market, return to the entrance, go to the monorail station, and then talk to someone who I don't see here.
Hmm.
So, I don't know, let's take her back and let's go to Kamoshio.
Alright. I was about to ask you to do a thing, but I'm pretty sure the game wouldn't let you do it.
Do what?
The hostess side missions with Haruka there. Just to see what the game would do.
I think we can try one. I don't see why not.
Because I'm pretty sure at the end of the last hostess side mission, he alluded to the fact that Kazuma fucked her.
Yep.
And I just want to see... I want to see how the game might address that with Haruka there. So, in those missions in previous games, which we didn't do them, did we?
No.
Like,
we haven't really touched those as much.
Do you end up sleeping with... Do you end up sleeping with them at the end of those ones as well?
I'm pretty sure.
Kazuma's an easy guy.
He has needs.
Easy going, at least. Yeah, he's with his daughter.
Okay.
I mean, like, you, c- you c- could have made it a family affair, lady.
Okay, yeah. So you were right.
Alright. It'd be funny and also weird if it did let you do the date mission with her alongside.
Yeah, it would be.
Just like Haruka standing in the background of cutscenes. That guy seems like he should have fought you. There we go.
One day I'll check the trophies. One day on a stream. Because the resolution changes between the cross-media thing. The PS3 UI. And when you start the game.
And that throws off all the sync, doesn't it?
Yeah, it fucks up the sync. Not as much as I accidentally did when I was starting to edit the last batch of episodes.
What did you do?
I accidentally imported your audio from the session before and didn't realize it. So the numbers lined up, because we always kind of do that in the same cadence, but then none of the conversations matched at all. And I was very confused.
You should have uploaded it, like... Just, you know, see if you caught anyone out, man.
Yeah, Arca, wanna go to the beach real quick before I ditch you? Not to do anything, I just wanna see if there's any trash to pick up. Beach cleanup, doing your... stewardship of your environment.
Give Haruka the gift she always wanted for Christmas.
Ocean junk.
A squishy ball.
Because I may have gotten one of the trash trophies, but I have definitely not gotten the pick up 30 pieces of trash trophy.
That would take forever.
Hi, dog. Hi, Bean.
Please remember to pick up a worm. The worm is incredibly important.
We have to take the swarm to Tokyo with us.
Also, just realized, we probably could have found out what we were supposed to do with Haruka by talking to her.
I think we chose to go somewhere with her.
Why would you choose to go with her?
I don't know. But now that we ditched her, there's like 50 bubbles popping up on the screen here.
There's so much we can do, man. And I bet you one of those things we can do are not go to camera action.
Taichi's bored.
I don't blame him for being bored. God, this kid with the bowl cut.
Needs a better haircut.
Bad bowl cut, man. It's incredibly bad. There's like a... It's like a whirlpool at the very center top of his head. It's not natural, man. It's not natural. How do you even make your hair grow outwards like that? Have we done the hide-and-seek thing before? I remember us talking about it once.
No, we had to go find everyone to talk about something.
Oh yeah, we had to talk about the kid being bullied.
Yeah.
Bowl cut kid, to be specific. Should it ever come as a shock that bowl cut kid got bullied?
No. He stood up for himself.
Did he really then?
I believe he punched the bully.
Pretty sure we ended up telling the teacher off. Yeah, he punched him. But I'm pretty sure that we're the ones who dealt with all the back of the scenes stuff. Or behind the scenes even.
Okay, I remember where one of these children is. I think. I thought.
I don't think they're over here. There is a way out back, by the way.
Yeah. Oh no, I might be thinking of the first time. Hey, are you in these boxes? No, but there's a fucking locker key back here.
Just hide in there, man. This is the real game of hide and seek.
Game we've been playing for 3 games.
Wait, I didn't even know there was this side of the house.
Yep.
I've never seen you walk around here.
I've done it once.
Oh, yep. This was actually the door I was thinking of, to the back.
But you have to go into third person to find them, and there's no third person here. So. Check out front. Let's see, these two.
Are they just.
We're not playing.
Part of the game, I don't think. See if you can get a tip from them.
They're making fruit and. Fruit jello?
Dude, these kids are like 7. I would not trust them with any oven.
You don't need an oven for jello. What kind of jello are you making over there?
I didn't know they were making jello.
It said they're
all I see is a huge dish on the oven.
It says they're putting fruit and gelatin.
These kids are surprisingly well hidden. They're not going to be on the mic, on the roof, Mikey.
You never know.
But there is one right down there. That looks like an incredibly uncomfortable place.
Yep. What?
What was that reference to?
I have no idea.
Also, that's a terrible hiding place, Izumi.
It's not a good hiding place at all.
Possibly one of the worst. All that's hiding you is a mesh. Alright, we gotta find Tai Chi and the bowl cut kid. And there's one of them. Alright, where could someone like Tai Chi be hiding? How the fuck? Wait, how? Well, why is he crouching down up there, by the way?
Low
He's
profile.
On the roof, there's no point in crouching. I was so confident nobody would be on the roof. I don't know how he even got up there. Wait, did he just voluntarily do housework?
I guess so.
Apache is not only a good hider.
Guide lied to me. Move, it said that you fail the mission if you don't find the one girl first. So there are more side quests to teach the dog tricks, but let's get to Tokyo.
Yeah. We've been on a slow march to Tokyo for about 10 hours now.
Yeah.
I still can't get over the flag on his shirt.
実は今日から1週間くらい東京に行く.
マジかよ!
いいの? 私も行きたい!
そうだよ! 一緒に連れてってよ!
私も行きたい!
聞いてくれ. 旅行に行くわけじゃないんだ. どうしても東京に行ってやらなきゃならないことがあるんだ.
This is like a sudden disconnect with the Kazuma I saw 2 minutes ago in this one.
You mean with his suit back on?
Yeah. Serious business time.
Sakida. Wake up the Hanashi of Surukota Dekina. Ima Saki no Otosanwa. Kegaoshite, Bioin ni Nuin Stale.
Right, forgot that happened.
Because that happened like
a month ago.
6 hours ago, maybe? Yeah. Taichi is very confident he can make people happy. Am I saying his name right? Is it Taichi or is it Taichi?
Taichi.
Say that again? Just,
Taichi.
Okay, so I do pronounce the I in the middle of it.
Yeah.
Alright.
1 second.
I'm gonna say his name with the utmost respect.
Got a plane ticket. Good job, Haruka.
Why did she have a plane ticket?
She bought it for us.
Did we make her organize it for us?
Probably.
Oh, now it wants us to go to the public market.
Yeah. Oh, now we have Haruka with us.
It's totally different from the last time we had her with us.
Because now it's plot mandated.
So was last time something we just volunteered to do ourselves?
I believe so. Which, I don't know why it gave us the option, but it's gonna make us do it anyway.
Are there Haruka-only specific side quests in this game? Where you have to have her with you to even trigger them?
In this one, I don't think so. Like, in the first one, there definitely were. I think.
Mm-hmm. But why would they let you trek her around town if they didn't?
I have no idea. Like
run, Granny. Run on those heels. Don't want to be near this fight. You know, for all the wind-up that move had, it did very little damage.
Well, I was looking for a dumb statue for you, but I can't find one.
You ruined my day, Mikey. You ruined it. Also, damn. Kazuma has a ton of blood in his hand right now.
Very much blood. Let's see how much blood this guy has all over him. A lot.
Everyone in this game, like, when you win a fight, they suddenly turn into a character from Dead Rising.
I can't hold anymore. Are you trying to give me resin? I don't want resin. Put it in the box.
It's super resilient, Mike.
Okay, I will look around the second floor. Let's look for locker keys until Haruka finds me.
I mean, like, we know there's none up here.
I mean, we don't have anything else to do but look.
On the bright side, since the last time we came upstairs here, Skype quality's fixed itself.
Oh, well, so that's good. See. Mm-hmm.
Skype video is a weird, weird thing.
It's not good. Well, it's peer-to-peer, I think. Which is part of the quality problems in general.
Mm. I imagine we're asking a weird thing of it by sending a video across basically the other side of the world?
Yeah, not quite, you're like, but pretty close.
Yeah, you're Pacific. Yeah, close enough. Probably as far as you're gonna actually send data.
I wanna pick the guy up, game.
You're like, wait, can you throw him over the edge? Yes, there we go. That.
I thought of it, and then I that tried it, dead. And it worked.
Mm-hmm. Whoa! You murdered my friend.
You didn't even think twice about it. You just did it.
Hmm. Nobody in this market's gonna pay their protection money now that you know. This got humiliated, man.
So they just want me to fight these two guys up here? And to throw all of them off the balcony?
Why do those guys stood up here in the cafeteria looking to pick fights? Why do you go to the cafeteria to pick a fight? Also, that's a tall dude.
I don't think my plan's gonna work.
Nah, I don't think it will.
Oh well, I did it to one person and that was worth it.
Mm-hmm. He probably went through someone's stall. You've ruined their day's income. How do you distinguish a multi-purpose thumbtack from a single-purpose thumbtack?
I don't know, maybe it says on the box.
Like, are there Maybe. But are there feature differences between the two?
For the purpose of this game, I don't think so.
How about reality, though?
I have no idea. I use thumbtacks almost entirely for hanging things on the wall, actually.
What ultimate functions could you have for a thumbtack? Like, what else can you really do with them other than hang things up?
Put them in a shoe in a Home Alone type situation?
Okay. I don't remember that bit from Home Alone.
I didn't say, I didn't mean like Home Alone specifically, but like that kind of situation.
For some odd reason, I was thinking like, put them on the underside of the shoe as in into the sole. And I was like, why would you do that?
No, you put them inside the shoe, you dummy.
Hmm. But it does remind me that I do know people who have put thumbtacks in the heel of their shoes before.
Why?
It was back when I was in the Army Cadets. Some people were really lazy about the driving their heel into the ground when they stand to attention.
Oh,
so
that makes
they
a better
put
sound.
A thumbtack. Mm-hmm. That way, you can put way less effort into it and get the same outcome.
Okay.
Generally, people who did that were complete knobheads. So. You're either really lazy, which meant you were never reliable in drill practice, or they were the kind of people who just want to show off by sounding the best.
I should be getting to the airport, Haruka.
What happens if you say it's still time? Can you miss your flight? Nope. We don't want to go anywhere.
Yeah, okay. Bye, Haruka.
Yep. We thought about it for a moment. Nah, go the fuck away, please. Haruka, in this very short journey home, is going to get kidnapped. I can guarantee it.
Who knows?
She's been kidnapped like 4 times already, though. At this point, it's just like... Every other week.
Okay, here we go.
Oh, okay.
Let me introduce you to Mack.
Hi, Mack.
He's gonna introduce us to a new system. Mechanic? Part of the game that they introduced in Kenzan.
So I guess we're gonna take photos for him? If he's a...
Kind of.
...photojournalist.
I absolutely do want to learn how to take revelations.
Him talking about revelations like this repeatedly sounds kind of creepy, Kazuma. Oh. Nobody talks about photography in terms of revelations. And epiphanies. I feel like he's going to give me a leaflet for his cult.
But revelations are very important, AP.
So, what year was this game again?
2009? 2010? 9, 10? Somewhere
2009 there. Sounds right. What quality do you think camera phones were back then?
Japanese camera phones are probably alright.
I'm gonna guess they probably weren't that good though.
Kazuma's learning about blogging.
Oh yeah. Gonna get him a MySpace account. Oh, what's the other internet blog everyone used to get back then?
I have no
idea. I can't remember what it's called. What do you think Kazuma would blog about? What would be his thing?
It certainly looks like he's gonna blog about this lady on the scooter.
I'm gonna start taking weird, creepy, candid photos of women on the street. Yep. Yep, he is. Okay. Oh. What? okay.
This is why revelations are very important.
Yeah, I can see why now. Is this also the thing you used, like the exact clip you used for that one video?
Not the exact clip. I picked the wrong thing at the end.
Yeah. Wait. She's gonna do the exact same thing again?
Yeah, you can't... they're not
like
missable.
It's like a Tony Hawk stunt right here.
Revelations aren't missable, luckily. This one? Am I gonna get them both? Or am I gonna get two wrong answers?
Why is there a question and answer section to this? Like, what is it expecting you to do there? There's not actually a question.
It's you trying to get insight into a new move.
Okay.
Well, this is the walkthrough section of this LP, telling you which ones are absolutely yeah. wrong.
Showing you every possible fail state.
It's not like that look left, look right game. You can absolutely not do this right.
No, you could fail the look left, look right game. It was just complete random chance.
This stands to be proven.
Well, I'm gonna start my own side Yakuza 3 LP. Where I get to that game a chance, and then it never ends. I'm just gonna continue to fail it for as long as I possibly can.
You heard it here first, folks. Instead of getting Digimon World next order, AP's gonna get a PS3 and Yakuza 3 to do that.
Mm-hmm. Hello and welcome to part 487 of AP's Yakuza 3 left-right game. This time I'm gonna pick right. He picked left. Okay, that's a blog. That is a blog right there.
Yep.
Born in 1968, eh?
He's an old guy.
Intro. I live in Okinawa and work at an orphanage. I write about epiphanies and the amazing events I see in the city. My motto is, read on. I want to know what his motto is.
I unfortunately cannot read on.
Also, it's a bit of a lie to say you work at an orphanage. You own and also run the entire orphanage on your own, man.
Essence of jumping. So we're gonna have to see what that is.
Like, saying you work at an orphanage is like a Paul Sewo statement right there. Like saying you live in Japan. It's not quite the truth.
I mean, it's more the truth than... than the statement you just made. Because he does work at an orphanage.
Yeah.
He's underselling instead of overselling.
Okay, yeah, it's the opposite, but it's equally wrong. In terms of how you use language. By the way, if people were wondering what I was referencing then, Paul Salo is an internet crazy person. He's the guy who decided to do 9/11 too. And, at one point he decided to try and stop a hotel in Japan, while also working there on a tourist visa.
Which you can't do.
It's
specifically
yeah.
disallowed.
He also claimed that he, he is not allowed to work on a tourist visa.
They do have working tourist visas, but not for Americans. Mm. Like, you, I believe,
also,
could get a working... Well, I don't know about now, but as of a few days ago, you could have gotten a working tourist visa.
What changed in the past few days?
You left the EU.
Well, we haven't left the EU yet.
Oh, did that not happen yet?
We're still leaving. Okay. It's going to be a 2-year process.
Okay, I thought once he signed the thing, it was outskies.
Nah.
Okay, so maybe he still can, I don't know.
There's even the possibility for us to backpedal on leaving the EU in the full list of things, but if we backpedal, that means we lose all the privileges we have in the EU. So our choice now is to leave or just become like every other member state. But the dude in these videos also claimed that he lived in Japan when he was there on a 90-day visa.
Yeah.
Bit of a stretch.
Okay, good. Mack will tell us when there's shots.
You know what? I think we're going to have a good relationship with this Mack guy. I can't wait for him to return.
Well, should we save and wrap this episode up?
Yeah, we probably should.
Okay.
We didn't do much.
We got revelations.
We went shopping with Haruka. Mm-hmm. We saw a woman flip her motorbike up in the air.
But?
Do the revelations persist in being that crazy going forward?
Yes, they do.
Okay, that's all I need to know.
Although, they got rid of them in Zero for whatever reason. I guess because we hadn't met Mack yet. We haven't learned about him.
Who knows? You could meet like a 10-year-old Mack.
I mean, unlocking the new fighting styles was basically a revelation.
It does seem to basically follow the same structure as that. It's less crazy.
Yep.
Except for the big dance one. That one's a bit crazy.
Yep. Anyway. This is GameCube Plays Yakuza 3. I'm Mike.
I'm another person of AP. And as always,
keep it juicy.
See you next time, folks.